Hello, I'm Chris. I'm a product manager on the Edge DevTools team, and this is what's new in the Edge Developer Tools for version 108. In version 108, we improved DevTools navigation via the Edge command palette. We also made improvements to the high contrast mode in DevTools. In focus mode, disabling JavaScript now displays a warning icon on the sources tool tab. In the styles pane, you can now see which CSS properties are inactive. We wrote documentation to make it easier for you to create your own tools. And finally, Microsoft Edge WebDriver is now available for macOS running on Apple M1. Let's dive in. First, we improved the navigation to DevTools tabs and panels from the Edge command palette. The Edge command palette is an experimental feature that allows users to perform common tasks in the Edge browser by using the Ctrl Q shortcut. In previous versions of Edge, some DevTools related commands for opening subpanels within the tools did not always navigate to the correct places. This issue is now fixed. As an example, you can open the command palette, type show snippets, and DevTools will open at the right place, making it possible to use your snippets right away. Next, we made several high contrast mode fixes to DevTools. Many people rely on the Windows high contrast mode to differentiate between sections of the user interface. We continuously improve support for the high contrast mode in DevTools. And in 108, we fixed the hover style of the contextual menu items, the selected tab label color, the console error messages color, and the focused links color. Next, in our focus mode UI experiment, disabling JavaScript now displays a warning icon on the sources tool tab. You can disable JavaScript from DevTools by using the command menu. Type Ctrl+Shift+P and then type disable JavaScript. While this is very useful for testing something temporarily, it can cause confusion if you don't realize that JavaScript is still disabled. Starting with version 108 in focus mode, the sources tool tab now shows a warning icon when JavaScript is disabled. To re-enable JavaScript, use the command menu again, press Ctrl+Shift+P and then type enable JavaScript. Moving on to CSS. The styles pane in the elements tool now provides warnings when certain CSS properties are not having any effect on the selected element. Depending on the element and on the styles applied to it, a CSS property may be valid but inactive. This means that the property does not change anything to the element's style or layout. As an example, setting a width or height on an inline element like a span does not actually do anything. While the width and height properties do apply and are valid, the browser just ignores them. While you may already be aware of this particular case, there may be many other more subtle cases that DevTools can help you with now, like using align content on a flex item instead of the flex container. DevTools now fades out the inactive properties and displays an information icon next to them. Hover the icon to learn more about why the property is inactive. We also published two new articles in our DevTools documentation to make it easier for you to create your own tools based on your own needs. First, we published a detailed step-by-step tutorial to create your own DevTools extensions. DevTools has more than 30 tools, but you may have a very specific use case that needs specific tooling. You can create a browser extension to add a new panel inside DevTools. The panel can then inspect the page and use a lot of advanced extension APIs to do useful things. To learn more, go to aka.ms/devtools-extension. And secondly, we published a schema of heap snapshot files. You can record snapshots of the memory used by a web page in DevTools and then save the snapshot as a file to disk. The resulting file contains a lot of memory information structured as JSON. This new article makes it easy to understand the JSON data and therefore create your own tools to investigate memory problems. Here is one created by José Luis Leal Chapa, an engineer on the DevTools team. To learn more, go to aka.ms/heap-snapshot-schema. And finally, Microsoft Edge WebDriver is now available for macOS running on Apple M1. On Apple M1 devices, Microsoft Edge WebDriver was previously running under emulation. Now it will run faster without emulation. To download Microsoft Edge WebDriver on Apple M1 devices, open Edge version in Microsoft Edge and identify the version of the browser that you want to automate, go to aka.ms/edge-webdriver, find the matching version of Microsoft Edge WebDriver and download the Mac M1 offering. We would love to get your feedback on this issue. Now, before we wrap this up, here's a tip that you may find useful. Did you know that you can list all of the DOM elements that your web page has in memory, but that are no longer attached to the page's DOM tree? While your web page may keep these detached elements on purpose, they can sometimes also indicate a DOM memory leak. To list them, open the Detached Elements tool. Make sure to click the Collect Garbage button to remove all elements that may still be in memory but not actually retained by your code. Click Get Detached Elements, and you can now see a list of elements still in memory but not attached to the page's DOM tree. review these elements to understand whether your code should get rid of them. To go even further, click Analyze to capture a heap snapshot. You can now also double-click in the ID column for any detached element to jump directly to the right place in the heap snapshot and investigate why the element is retained. And that's it for today. If you have feedback, ideas, feature requests, or bugs, join our community on GitHub at github.com/microsoftedge/devtools. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at msedgedev and like and subscribe to stay tuned for what's coming next in 109.